Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to my channel, and it's time to do first episode of PSVR Super Show, my brand new show. Usually at this time of the week we have a look at PSVR the wrap-up, but thanks to the successful Patreon start, I've been able to put this together. This is my by far the biggest show. We've got tons and tons of stuff to talk about. Of course, you're gonna have the wrap-up section, but also you're gonna have some gameplay and preview of Bullet Sorrow. I had a chance to play the demo and I'm gonna tell you what the game is like. But also you're gonna look at other stuff like Bullshit Watch, perhaps, which is basically me looking at the latest PS5 rumors and telling you how much stupid they are. There's tons of different segments. Just have a look at them while you're watching, and that's how you can learn about this show more. But also, this is starting as the live premiere. I've tried yesterday and it's worked great. Tons of you joined in. We was able to chat in the chat. So that's what I'm gonna try to do more often as well. But anyway, let's start PSVR Super Show. And the first segment of the show is Bullshit Watch. So let's have a look what the press been telling us about PlayStation 5 and PlayStation VR 2. We've had reports from Bloomberg that everyone jumped on straight away and been like, okay, this is the truth. I was like, this is probably not the truth. So what's happening is they've done report, they said Sony struggles with the PS5 price. It's so expensive that $450 minimum, that's how much it's gonna cost. Listen, let's just remember that Sony usually is good with the pricing of their consoles, apart from PS3 of course, but they learned their lesson. Now PS4 started at $399, which means one thing: if it's $450, Sony's done great job, because $399 in today's money is $440. As we know, Sony likes to sell PS4s at the loss and then they get in their money from game sales and PS Plus subscriptions and all that stuff. But also, to put things into the perspective, back in the day when PS4 been launching, we've had same story with same articles, what been saying that Sony is losing $60 on each PlayStation 4. That's come back in the day from the industry insiders and anonymous sources. So as you can see, it's same story just over and over, each generation repeating itself, and this is only done to get, you know, some good clicks and good ad money. It's important to get those, the ad revenue for any channels and any internet publications existence. But also you have to like take back from it and sit back and think like, let me just look more into it. So not only $450 seems like it's win for Sony because they only gonna lose a tena, but also it means it's probably not even true and Sony definitely gonna appropriately price their console. Will it be $399? I have no idea, but I'm assuming it won't be any more than $500 as well. And also I'm gonna put link in the description so you can read Eurogamer's article when they've been saying Sony is just selling PS4s at loss, just to see that the same narrative goes each generation. Also, let's display some PS4 concept designs. Apparently we've had so many leaks that people know how PS5 gonna look, but as you can see, it was same story with PS4, which was basically not true, because when PS4 came out, everyone was like, whoa, what a strange design, like a slated design, like a sandwich, what is it? Nobody expected that, and I'm assuming it's gonna be same story when Sony finally reveals PS5. Regarding the reveal, we don't know when it is. Don't believe rumors that it's February. Very well might be, but it might not be as well, so just keep that in mind. Also, same article spoke about PlayStation VR 2, and what they say is Sony will release PSVR 2 after PS5. Yeah, of course that's gonna happen. It's like me saying Sony is working on games and they're gonna make some new games. They will happen. That's basically what this article said. We already know that Sony gonna support PSVR. They said in past they've got big plans for PlayStation VR. That's all what we know. PSVR 2 probably will come. Sony didn't announce anything themselves yet, so the only official info is that Sony will support PSVR. Of course your PSVR will work on PlayStation 5 as well. all your games should work on PlayStation 5 as well, what you've got on your PS4. So just keep that in mind and try not to believe too much what you're reading on the internet. Another story that qualifies for bullshit watch is what I read about Sony patenting this super special patent what lets people buy the answers to the game what they didn't knew. If you get stuck, you can pay and then the game will tell you. Of course, after this patent, many publications says that's what Sony gonna do with PS5. Listen, Sony won't do that with PS5. If you get stuck in the game, as we know what everyone does is jumping straight to YouTube and try to find a walkthrough, so I don't see how they would make money from it. But also, of course, you can always try to beat the game yourself if it's proven to be bit challenging. Sony did patent it. It is true. My best guess is maybe it's for mobile markets, maybe it's for like everyone, not only PS5. I don't know. Or maybe somebody patented it because they was thinking, yeah, let's just in case, let's just patent it. We've got this idea. We better have it patented. But when they look at it, they think like, yes, this idea is pretty stupid, but at least it's patented. You never know, that's what might happen, but don't worry, you won't have to pay to beat your games. That will never happen. So that's the another story done. So this was the first segment of the show. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know in comment section what you think to the each segment. Now let's move on to the next part, which is next week games. Of course, we only get in Bullet Sorrow. I already done PSVR the drop about it, but let me do a little preview about it as well, because I downloaded the demo on PC, played a bit of it. I didn't want to play too much, of course, to not spoil myself PS4 version. So yeah, let's have a look at Bullet Sorrow's gameplay and let's do a little preview. Okay, so as you can see, this gameplay captures itself by grabbing footage from each eye. That's how old this game is. Come out like 3 years ago, one of first VR games on PC as well. First of all, let me just tell you this, when it's released, it's had PvP, you know, you could play in co-op and player versus player. From what I'm reading, PSVR version won't have it, so just keep that in mind, it looks like it. Hard to find out a lot because the developers are very quiet, but anyway, how it plays. So basically, it is a teleportation and click turning only. Will they update it for PSVR version? I have no idea. Did it felt outdated? Yes it did. So what you're doing, you've got two controllers, you've got your triggers to shoot, then you've got your button to teleport, and with your thumbsticks on PC you turn, so I'm assuming it's been doing by, you know, pressing, clicking on move controllers. And then your enemies like coming at you in wave, you kind of enclosed in one area. You can move around it, but not a lot. You cannot progress until you kill enough enemies, and then the game gonna have little blackout moment, be like, whoa, let me just load myself, and then you're gonna go to the other small area. That's how it works. Now, this turning kind of felt a bit laggy, so it wasn't as reactive as I would like. Something what makes a lot of appearance in older VR games. And also this teleport, it didn't teleport at you that far away, only very short distance, so very outdated. Like I said, it did felt outdated, but also it's had some pretty cool moments. So this is a cover shooter, so your best way is to teleport yourself behind like a box or something. Boxes in this game, they are indestructible. Your enemies might be from the future, but everyone carries normal guns, but the boxes, holy shit, they are futuristic. Nothing breaks them, maybe just big explosions. Your enemies like to place themselves next to explosive barrels. They think that's the good idea. So what you do, you shoot in, it's one button reload, so you can hide, and then you reload once you crouch in, and then you can shoot again. But what I like the most about it is the bullet time abilities. It's recharging itself, so you have to wait for it, then you press button, everything nicely slow down, you've got like this nice effect. And you just shoot in as fast as you can, the bullet shells flying everywhere, and the kills are quite satisfying. Now, this is not your typical wave shooters, where the waves after waves of enemies coming at you and just stay in one place. The enemies running around, they come at you, then they gonna change position. They're kind of smart, they gonna try to surround you, so you have to like move a lot around. It gets quite difficult, and also there was like enemies was started easy, and then there was different types in the demo. So that is my impression of this game. Nothing super extra groundbreaking, but from what I played, like I said, I didn't wanted to play too much, but I feel like I want to play more. I had a good impressions, but keep in mind it does feels like the old VR games, like it's got elements of older VR games that today kind of not making a lot appearance. Sometimes it happens when the game is shit, but the shooting and everything else and enemies AI discover system and bullet time felt really good. So of course I'm gonna try to review this game. I contacted the developers, it's a Chinese company, so I don't know how they doing down there. Of course coronavirus, many everything is pretty much shut down there, nobody works, seems like it. So I don't know if I get code or if I pick it up from the store, but definitely I'm gonna try to do review and definitely I'm gonna want to play a bit more just to have some fun with this game. Okay, so that was our only next week game. As we know, this beginning of the year is a bit dry. Week after, I think you get in like 3 or 4 releases, so that will be alright. But anyway, on to the next segment, which is PSVR, the wrap-up. And this is a segment when I'm taking all the biggest news story, putting them together into one nice little package, throwing them at you and then telling you what about it. So first of all, let's start from the new games announcement, and only new game announced was A Room Where Art Conceals. This gameplay coming from Dave Station VR. The game is already out on Hong Kong store, so that's where he's got it from. But basically it's for you, all your art people who enjoy it, you're probably gonna enjoy that. Because you kind of enter in the art, like Van Gogh art, yeah, you might like that, very creepy, strange things happening, but you like walking through it, so it might look like painting, but you actually walking through it, and apparently it feels great. There is no release date for it yet, but it will be coming soon, maybe month, maybe less, and you should have it. It's gonna be very cheap as well. On Hong Kong store is under $10 when you translate money. So I'm assuming $8-$9, that's what you're gonna pay. And it's quite Polish experience, so definitely looking nice. But anyway, that was only new announcement. What was the news? What the release dates we've got? Space Channel 5 will be releasing on February 25th at the price of $39.99. So, you know, you might think, that's quite expensive, I don't know if this is worth it. But listen, if you don't want to pay, or if you're not sure if you want to pay, then before the game releases, you can download the demo, because at the same day, the free demo will be on the store as well, so you'll be able to download it and try it and see what it looks like. Developers in past said, don't think that it's the same game like Space Channel 5 on Dreamcast. It's different game, we remade it. It's not just a remake, it's remade game with different elements and shit. So it should be something what many people might enjoy. If you played original, then this is kind of a bit different. What changed is definitely the motion controls. Anything else, I don't know yet, but when it comes out, I'm gonna try to cover it. And another release we've had is Down the Rabbit Hole. And this is prequel to the Alice in Wonderland. Alice went there and she saw some crazy stuff. But before Alice went there, the other girl went there and she saw even more crazy stuff, because she was in VR, which was you. You are a girl in Wonderland. It's all told like in a diorama world around you. You're seeing it in a third person, but then you're gonna go do puzzles and it's gonna put you in the first person. You'll be like, oh, right, that feels real. I need to solve it. So that's Down the Rabbit Hole. I really like what I'm seeing from it, coming from the Cartopia Studios. They released Once in Past, this is their second game, much, much bigger as well. And it looks like a very story-driven game. Of course, if you like Alice in Wonderland, you're gonna get to see all your favorite characters, probably. So yeah, very, very interesting. But anyway, that's not everything. Apart from release dates, we've had some news. And we're gonna start from the Dreams VR support. First of all, the game got awesome reviews. Everyone loves it, this is amazing, but also regarding PSVR support, shouldn't be that long, developers saying. They said in past many times, yes, it's gonna be during this generation, before PS5 releases, so it just seems, from what I'm reading, it just seems like around the corner, maybe 5-6 months, maybe less, and we should get it. Regarding the PS5, of course, they said it's working on PS5 already, like we know PS5 gonna be backwards compatible. They said there will never be Dreams number 2, and I like how they said, did you ever saw YouTube 2? No, you didn't. What's happening is YouTube released and they just working on it all the time. Very popular, they released YouTube for people to make videos, and that's what they did with Dreams, they released it for people to make games. So it looks like it might be going on forever and ever. already some awesome creations. If you didn't had a chance to play it, get it as soon as possible. A lot of stuff to learn, but definitely well worth picking up. Plus, if you can be asked to make your own game, loads of games out there already what you can play. Some of them, you know, not that good. Some of them proper awesome. So definitely Dream, huge success. No other company, I can't see anyone else letting their studio pump in tons of money to it and saying, yeah, go ahead, do it. Sounds crazy, but do it. Only with Sony this could happen, and I'm very, very grateful for it. Okay, next story. Let's talk a bit about Gorn. Everyone wants to know about it all the time. What about Gorn? Well, only new info the developers gave us is they said yes, it will include endless mode like on PC, but also they told us the price and it will be $20. There's nothing else what we know what they said, and if you're trying to get angry with the developers that they don't share in anything, listen, they're working on the game, but they've got nothing new to share just yet. They said their next announcement will be once they pass all the Sony submission process and everything. So they send it to Sony, it takes I don't know how much, 2 weeks, maybe more for Sony to respond. Then they might say, okay, you're good to go, or they might say, listen, you have to fix few bits and bobs. And then they have to resubmit, which is another 2 weeks or so, then Sony will come back. So the game seems to be finished, now they're just doing this Sony submission. And listen, they really worked hard for it. It's not like they don't want you to play it, they cannot wait for you to play it. But also they want this port to be proper good, just like PC players got. They want you to have same experience, and you just cannot rush those things. Sometimes you have to give it time, you have to let the game cook, and then when it releases and it's properly cooked, then you're gonna enjoy it and it's gonna be super tasty. Of course, if the game is undercooked, it's shitty, and then it needs to recook in, and it never works like that great. So let them work on it, it will happen, and the next announcement probably will be release date. Okay, and next story, coming back to Crysis Brigade. This is a bonus news. What's happening is the developer tweeted lately that they've had their session with PSVR playing against PCVR, I mean with PCVR people in co-op, and it works super smoothly. They said PSVR co-op is happening faster than they thought. The development going very smoothly, so very soon you might get co-op update for Crysis Brigade. And of course that will be for free, and then you'll be able to play with your friends. Very, very challenging, but very fun game as well. And of course, if you like Time Crisis, then this is something what you want to look at. If you didn't play it yet, supports aim controller and it feels great. Doesn't look much, but packs a punch. Okay, and next part of the show is power ratings, which is basically top 10 lists. And today I'm gonna look at top 10 upcoming PlayStation VR games. Next week we're gonna have my top 10 list of my favorite PSVR games. And week after we're gonna have your top 10s. So listen, if you want to vote on your games, hashtag PSVR ratings in comment section and just write your favorite games. Don't have to be top 10, but it would be helpful if it was. I'm gonna count it all out, I'm gonna read every comment, the game's gonna get points, depends how many times they will appear in comment section, and then you're gonna put it all together, and in 2 weeks time you're gonna get your own top 10 list by viewers of this channel. So it's all gonna be circulating each week. It's gonna be mine, yours and upcoming games, and it's gonna change the depends what we like, games and stuff like that. But anyway, what is top 10 upcoming games for PlayStation VR at the moment? And I'm basing it by my own observations and personal feelings toward the game, but also I'm basing it on by how relevant the games are, how many times they appear in my comment section, how many times I'm seeing them being spoken about in various forums, and of course Reddit and that. I'm reading it all, so let's just do it. At number 10 we've got Undead Citadel. This game is scheduled to come out in Q2 2020, so between April and July. Now listen, I had a look at the Steam page store and it's saying early access, and usually this is the indication that PC players gonna get it first. Then the developers gonna work on the game, PC players basically gonna be like kind of beta testers of the game. They're gonna be adding content, and then when the game fully release on PC, then probably gonna get PSVR version. Unless those tags are just mistakes, but that's what it looks like at the moment. Of course, this is one of those combat slashy bashy games when you get in to chop your opponents to bits. Gonna support 3D Reader as well, but those games are best played standing. and it just looks good. At number 9 we've got Walking Dead Onslaught from Survios. Now, I know you're waiting for Saints and Sinners, this is very anticipated game, but don't sleep on Onslaught because it's totally different game. Saints and Sinners, very story driven, very long campaign, about 16 hours to complete. Onslaught and very arcade experience, what you can play with your friends in co-op. So totally different game, more action focused, but supposed to be fun. Of course Survios, I trust them a lot because it's a very experienced developer. I think they delayed it because they saw what Skydance doing with Saints and Sinners and then they've been like, shit, yeah, let's just work a bit more on it. But from what I saw already, definitely one of those very fun games that you can jump at any time, invite your friends and play together, just go and kill as many zombies as you can and have tons of fun. And at number 8, personally this is one of my favorites, but not many people talking about it, so I just put it at number 8. Atex Cybernetic. Now, to me, I played it on PC. They had big update not that so long ago, so the game got about 4-5 hours campaign now. It does feels to me like Doom VFR should feel. You've got melee combat, but also you've got your weapons, you can dual wield weapons, very hands-on game, tons of enemies to kill, very frantic action, I really enjoyed it a lot. Story-wise, you know, you don't need that much story to this game, it just focused on very brutal combat. And, you know, you go into space and things go to shit, so you're just fighting demons. That's what usually happens in those types of games. Okay, next game. At number 7 we've got Alvo. This game keep looking better and better every time the developers speak about it. They've been posting some new screenshots, how much they improved the game. I know when they released the gameplay for the first time, people was like, this not looking so good, why? I don't like it. But listen, this was the pre-alpha footage. The game definitely gonna look much different when it releases. But they doing all the right things. There will be different game modes, but also they gonna have dedicated servers. Of course, aim controller support is a given, but you don't need it if you got DualShock. Moves I don't think will be supported, but nevertheless it's just gonna be tons of fun, especially if you like your firewall, then it might be another one to your collection. At number 6 we've got Big Screen VR. I lately spoke about this game. Now listen, regarding what's happening with PSVR version, they wanted to have it in Q1 2020. Website just says 2020 now, so it looks like it's gonna be a bit later. They've been talking on Discord lately and basically what they said, the PSVR port proves to be difficult, so they must to spend more time on it, but definitely it will be coming in 2020. In Big Screen VR you not only can watch movies, but it's a very nice social app when you can just hang around with people. Of course, watching television is the meaning and the message, but there are different activities, you can draw and stuff, you can play games together. Basically, if you got flat game, you can invite your friends and play together. If you play like online and you see it on one screen. So, a lot of nice features. They added this cinema mode where you can go to cinema, purchase ticket, and you can watch 3D movies in VR. Of course, PSVR headset resolution not so great, but it's if you're watching your DVDs on your PSVR and you don't mind it, then that's how it's probably gonna work on the big screen. Definitely a big deal to me. I'm having fun with it on PC, with PSVR, you know, being so much comfier and everything. Definitely gonna use it more and it's just so much stuff to do. They've got proper television channels as well. So yeah, looks cool. But anyway, another game, and number 5 is Zero Caliber. This is coming from the same developer that bringing you Atex Cybernetic, just spoke about it, super awesome. But Zero Caliber, never had chance to play it, but from what I'm hearing, very very fun. You've got your story campaign when you like super special force going around the world doing the missions, saving the people. But also you can play it all in co-op with your friend, very nice. But what the developer said, when the game launches on PlayStation VR, it will have PvP mode. Something what PC players don't have it yet, but it will be there on PlayStation VR. So you'll be able to play against your friends as well. And also what they're doing, they're not promising 100% yet, but they're saying, listen, we're trying our hardest to do aim controller implementation. So it might be even supporting that, and that would be great. Now, number 4 is Gorn. So I just spoke about the price of the game. I just told you all the info what there is. The developers just working hard on it. I'm reading their Discord every day, going to their Twitter and everything. They bombarded by comments from PSVR owners and everyone just asking, hey, hey, where it's gone? And they just not stopped responding now because they did their video and they said, listen, we just working on it super hard. You gonna play it, you gonna get it. But you know, no matter how many times you ask, it's not gonna make the game coming out faster. But they do understand how much PSVR owners want to play the game. Therefore, it's probably, that's why it's take a bit longer. They don't want any fuck-ups. They want you to have exactly same version as PC players. That second time I'm talking about Gorn in this video. That's how much anticipated this game is. Of course, let me know in comment section what you think to Gorn. Now, let me tell you my impressions from what I played on PC version. Because on screen, it doesn't look much. It looks like you're doing same thing over and over. This game got about 3-4 hours campaign and it's super fun. Each stage giving you different weapons, you experimenting. The power of this game is in the fact that things just sometimes happen by accident. You can discover some hilarious, awesome use for a weapon just by accident. Also, after so many waves of enemies, you're gonna get boss battles as well. Bosses are great, crabs, Achilles, you can fight Achilles as well, you can fight giant crab, you can find some super powerful gladiator. So story mode is very interesting this campaign, it's not boring at all. Of course you've got your endless mode as well, and also there is a piñata mode, and piñata mode will be on PlayStation as well. This is for people who when they see blood they go like, oh, I just gonna pass out. That's how I replay passing out. So everything is a very nice, colorful piñata. Okay, next game, number 3 is Sniper Elite VR. Since the announcement of this game, we didn't hear that much from the developers at all. All we know, they're working hard on it. Lately, they said on Twitter, listen people, we achieved some kind of milestone. They didn't said what the milestone is, but I'm assuming it's something regarding Sniper Elite VR. But also, they taking this game around with them to various game shows, showcasing to people, and impressions are great. Now, it will support your aim controller. If you don't have it, it will support DualShock. If you don't have DualShock, that's impossible, but if you got moves, if you was lucky one to buy them before they sold out, then you'll be able to use moves as well. Regarding the locomotion options, smooth locomotion, smooth turning all the way, unless you feeling puky, then you're gonna have your click turning and teleportation blinders on off. So they just think about everything before they actually announce this game. Regarding the release date, I have no idea. The rumors say it is late 2020, but like I said, it's only a rumor. Might come earlier or the rumor might be true, I don't know. But it's definitely will be this year. I cannot wait, looks awesome. But anyway, next game. At number 2, we've got Iron Man VR. Now, this is got delayed. We should see it very soon. At the end of February, we should have this game. Sadly, the thing's gone to shit and the developers had to delay it. Always saying better delay and give me better game than rush it and it's not as good. It will be coming now in May, sadly, so very long wait, but definitely a good looking game. Okay, before I go to number 1, let me give you some honorable mentions. After the Fall, now in my last upcoming PSVR, top 20 upcoming PSVR games, I've put it on number 1. You might think, why you not putting it on this list now at all? But like I said, I'm going by not only my preferences, but also how relevant the game is and how many people talking about it, and sadly, nobody been really talking about it. So it's great. I'm sure when the developers gonna show some more footage, more people's gonna start get excited about it and talking more about this game. Coming from Arizona Sunshine developers, and this is a game when you can play in co-op, kill some zombies, kill some massive bosses, proper story mode, looks amazing. And my second honorable mention, go to Hellsplit Arena. I'm not putting it on the list just yet because it's not officially announced yet. That's only reason why. What's happening is the developers are in talks with Sony about porting it to PlayStation VR. Probably Sony gonna approve because it's a big title, but they said they cannot announce it yet. Once they got good to go from Sony, everything is sorted, then they gonna give you the announcement. And final honorable mention goes to the Blade and Sorcery. I know everyone wants it, but you're not getting it at all at the moment. They said once they release 1.0 version for PC, which is slated for December 2020, then after that they're gonna start working on PSVR version if technically possible. So basically they have to check if they actually can make it for PSVR. Might not be due to power, might just be controls, I don't know. But it would be awesome if it was coming. Okay, and now number one is Walking Dead Saints and Sinners. Amazing game, it's got such a good reviews, everyone loved it. This is one of the bigger VR games and this is VR game made from the ground up as a triple L game, huge studio behind it. Shout out to Skydance Interactive, they kind of went bold in VR and I don't think they're getting enough credit because they had to spend shit tons of money on this game. I saw photo of the team, there's like 50 people working on this game or something like that. Very huge game, very nice reviews, apparently combat feels great. Physics are amazing in this game and then just is nothing bad I could say on about it. Now, I've got the game on PC, I'm gonna play it and I probably gonna do feature about it. Who knows, might be next week, I don't know, in the next PSVR Super Show. But what's happening with PSVR version is they working on it as we speaking. In past they've been saying Q1, but now they saying Q1 closer to spring. So we might see it at the end of March. And listen, this is a big studio, they already released Archangel VR, they know how PSVR work, they know how to optimize their game. So don't worry, I don't expect any delays from them. We should see it when they said we're gonna see it. Maybe even very soon we're gonna get release date announcement for PlayStation VR. Who knows, but definitely something worth being excited for. Okay, and now shout out to the new patrons. I couldn't do it without you. So thank you very much. Thanks to the successful patron, this show actually is possible. I'm able to record such a long video, you know, come a bit later to work, have more sleep. So thank you very much. But also big shout out to the Village MPs, which are the highest patron, highest tier supporters. So thank you very much, Village MPs, you did great. And of course, all of you other patrons, I appreciate all of it. You make the show, the PSVR super show happened thanks to you. I've got many, many big plans for this show, like some exclusive reveals and everything like that. This is just kind of like pilot episode. Let's see how many views it's gonna get. Of course, the better the views, the better chances I've got getting it out there to the developer and saying, hey, you want your game on my show? Look how good it is, look how many people watches. So we shall see how it's all gonna turn out, but of course, if you want to help, you can become patron. And also, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And also, because it's first episode, try to share it with your friends. Get as many people to watch it as possible. And of course, if you're not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.